Hey guys, welcome to today's video. We're going to be going over the latest breaking news in the NFL. Before we get started, please drop a like and a sub on today's video. That would really help my channel grow. I'd really appreciate that. Also, if you're new around here, please comment your thoughts on my analysis and my channel in today's comment section down below. Really appreciate that too. And with that said, let's dive right into the video and I hope you enjoy. The last thing I want to do is speculate about what this injury is, but I do want to bring some light to the Baltimore Ravens run game without J.K. Dobbins, how this affects this Ravens offense next season. This is a tough injury. I mean, when you see a guy go down to the ground, clutch his leg, clutch his knee especially, you obviously first thing you think of is torn ACL. I'm not saying that's what it is. We don't know what it is yet. But when a player clutches their knee and then they have to be carted off the field, it's never a good sign. It's never a good sign. This is a crushing injury for this Ravens team. It's really a crushing injury. This guy last year, 805 rushing yards, 9 rushing touchdowns, 6 average yards per carry, 3rd highest in the league, 11th most rushing touchdowns in the league, 18th most rushing yards in the league. I mean, this guy's a good running back. He's young. Taken out of Ohio State in the second round last year. This is tough for this Ravens team. I mean, they're a run-heavy team, a run-based team, and yes, that starts with Lamar Jackson, but J.K. Dobbins is expected to have a massive year this year, mostly because of his effectiveness in the red zone, but he's good as a pass catcher. This is a huge blow, and I mean, he was injured on a screen play. This was a play designed for J.K. Dobbins, and it's frustrating in a few ways. Firstly, of course, it's one of their best players on offense, and of course, if you lose one of your best players on offense, and I think it's going to be a serious injury, it's going to be out for a while, that's not ideal. That's the first thing. Second thing, especially for a guy like Coach Harbaugh, who, you know, for years has been talking about how he doesn't like preseason because of injuries and potential injuries, this is really frustrating for him because he's been preaching this for a while. More frustrating, though, is that at the end of the day, you lose your star running back. Good news for Baltimore, though, is they have a solid backup in Gus Edwards, who throughout his 3-year career in Baltimore has actually been pretty consistent. He's rushed for over 700 yards each of the first 3 years, with 718 yards in his rookie season, 711 in 2019, and 723 yards in 2020. We saw his touchdown numbers go a lot up last season, but this guy can get it done in the red zone. He can catch the ball out of the backfield a little bit, not as well as Dobbins can. But in other words, Gus Edwards, he's a bigger back. He's 6'1", 240 pounds. He's a downhill runner, not afraid of contact. He's a different running back to Gus Edwards, to J.K. Dobbins. He's less explosive, but he's going to be the starter. He's going to be the starter, and he's going to get the majority of carries. And I think with this running game and with the Ravens offense, Gus Edwards will be fine. I mean, he will put up close to 800, 900 yards next year. He'll have 8-9 touchdowns probably. And he'll replace what Dobbins was supposed to do. Will he be as effective as Dobbins? Absolutely not. But at the end of the day, I don't think the Ravens are completely done, and I don't think their offense is shot. It's just a tough blow to lose one of the better, young, talented players in the league and a guy like J.K. Dobbins. And at the end of the day, you know, the severity of the injury hasn't come out yet, but anytime you've got to be carted off the field, player can't walk under their own power, clutching their knee, it's never a good sign. I'm not saying he's out for the year, but it's definitely not looking good. So for fantasy perspective, which we'll get into, obviously pick up Gus Edwards if you can, but this is just a really tough blow to this Ravens offense. I think they'll end up being fine just because Gus Edwards, and they added some power to this offense, but I think losing Dobbins is definitely not going to make them as powerful as they could have been. I still think they'll be a successful offense this year. I just think it's going to be hard to replicate that same passing effectiveness, especially with the running back, and how good J.K. Dobbins was as a pass catcher. I think that's really going to hurt them moving forward, but at the end of the day, you know, tough blow, really, really big loss, and it's just, you know, prayers up for J.K. Dobbins.
And with that said, that's pretty much going to end the video for today. Did you agree with my analysis? Why or why not? Leave your comments and thoughts in the comment section down below. I'd love to hear what you guys have to say. Also, if you're new around here, please drop a like and a sub on today's video. I'd really appreciate that. And with that said, I hope you enjoyed the video, and until next time, see ya.